Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our SM series flow sensors. In today's video, we are going to go over the installation guidelines for how to install these sensors. So let's get started. So here we have the Learn More section on our website for our SM series flow sensors. Under the Setup and Support section, you can find helpful information in getting your sensor set up. In today's video, we are going over the installation guidelines. In this section, you can find this video, as well as information on the direction of flow, recommended mounting locations, electrical grounding, and straight pipe run requirements. The first section we're going to go over is the direction of flow. On all of our SM sensors, there is an arrow that indicates the direction of flow. If flow goes in the opposite direction, it is represented with a minus sign on the display of the sensor. This can also be programmed using a parameter in the SM sensor in which you can program what direction of flow the sensor goes in. One thing to note is that the analog and switching signals are based on flow only in the direction of flow. These signals cannot be set for flow in the opposite direction. The next section goes over mounting locations. As long as these meters are installed in closed-loop system where no air bubbles can form, the orientation of the sensor is not critical. However, we still provide images of recommended and not recommended installation setups. So for example, you can see here, we recommend installing the sensor in a horizontal pipe before a vertical rising bend or in the vertical rising pipe. Below, we also have suggestions of what not to do. Next, we're going to go over the electrical grounding. Because of the technologies these sensors use, which is magnetic inductive technology, the meters involve measuring a voltage induced when a conductive media flows through a magnetic field. Because of this, the sensors need to be grounded to earth. So if they are mounted in a plastic pipe where they are not earth grounded, you need to use a grounding clamp such as the E40234 to ground it back to earth. Next, we are going to go over the straight pipe run requirement. Good practice suggests that you have 3 times the pipe diameter in front of the sensor and 1 times the pipe diameter after the sensor. However, if you know there are no air bubbles in the line and no air bubbles can form, you do not necessarily need any straight pipe in front or after these SM sensors. One thing to consider is that if the media of the temperature reaches above 122 degrees Fahrenheit, parts of the sensor housing can reach above 149 degrees Fahrenheit. So we provide a warning label that can be applied to the sensor housing as a good caution. So next I'm going to take you to the datasheet where you can find more specific details on these SM sensors. So now if you scroll back up to the top of your page, there is this enter search term section where you can enter your specific part number. So in today's video, I'm going to enter SM6020. And if you hit enter, a small description and picture of your part number will pop up. If you click on the part number in the orange font, it takes you to the full data sheet. So here you can see technical details on your specific part number, as well as you can go to the download section and find the full operating instructions manual. So next I'm going to show you how to get back to the Learn More page from this data sheet. So here at the top, you can see where it says flow meters with magnetic inductive technology type SM. If you click on this, it'll take you to an overview page of our type SM sensors. And here you will see the orange Learn More button. If you click on this, it gets you back to our Learn More section and back to the Setup and Support section. So there you have it. That concludes this Tech Insights video on the installation guidelines of our SM series flow sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at our service center at 1-800-441-8246 if you have any further questions. Thank you for your time and have a great day.